Going into the cave is a little bit intimidating, and it involves some vertical rock climbs, and then you have to go down into what's called the Dinnelady chamber, which is quite a deep chamber. It requires a 12-meter squeeze where it's so tight you can't have your head facing forward. You have to have your head turned to the side as you go down. And it's vertical, so you're rock climbing while squeezing, and then it opens up, so it's challenging. The coolest research discovery that I've been a part of is recently in 2015, we announced the discovery of a new human ancestor, Homo naledi, from a really deep cave system in South Africa. For me to be able to work on this project, and there's only a very few fossils of hominids or hominins in the world, is remarkable. So geosciences is the study of Earth systems. So Earth systems are everything from the rocks that we see around us, the soil, the water that sits beneath, so the groundwater. And it's really just taking the Earth and what we see and sort of making sense of it. Geoscientists work basically all over the world. One of the real advantages and exciting aspects of geology is the opportunity to travel and see amazing places. So our students will go into environmental industry, they'll go into mining, they'll go into oil and gas. Many of them will go into government and management positions. One of the differences you can make as a geologist is helping in the search for green materials. So as we move towards greener, more sustainable energy, for instance, a lot of that requires the discovery and the exploration for minerals that we didn't traditionally search for, things that we use in making solar panels and making lithium batteries. One of the advantages of a program that has a lot of field trips is that being a geologist or a geoscientist in general requires really understanding rocks and minerals and mountains and how the Earth works. And so there's really no better way or place to do that than outside. We have one of the very highest rated programs in Australia. And we also have the outback, we have the rainforest, we have the reef right at our doorstep. And if you want to study geology, you need to put your hands on the rocks. You need to look at the rocks, and the rocks are here. With the rapid development of green energy and the need for new materials, new discoveries of different things to produce batteries, solar panels, there's a real need and shortage out there for geoscientists.